Okay, hello guys, I am Satyam Shivhare and you are watching Learn Anything. Well, we have completed about 5 videos on the HTML5 and this series is all about intermediate and beginner people. I have already told you about this and in the sixth part of this series, I'm gonna tell you about links, okay? So 6th, 7th and 8th part will be about links and the videos will be pretty short, okay? Because links are actually a very easy topic for beginners and intermediate people, okay? So let me first tell you what the links are, okay? So in this video, I'm not gonna show you any presentations about links and all because it is very easy to understand, okay? And I can make you understand it very clearly. So as you know that whenever you visit a web page, okay, then for example you visit Wikipedia web page, you can just go ahead and in the references tab you can see a lot of colored text, okay, which on clicking actually takes you to the different web page for new information. So those texts are called hypertext, okay, and those texts are actually links and those links are called hyperlinks, okay. Link means that hypertext is actually a text which contains a link, okay, and that the link which it contains is actually called hyperlink. Links are something that actually appear on the top of the web browser. For example, this is the web browser and let's say we write something like this: www.google.com, okay. So this is actually a link, this is a link, okay, and we actually put these kind of links into the text and make those text hypertext, and these links are actually called hyperlinks. So these are the links which actually takes us to the different web page with the help of hypertext, okay. So in order to create a hypertext, we need a tag in the HTML, okay, because we will be creating links with the help of HTML. CSS is not something that we use to create links, however we can actually modify how the links actually look to the user with the help of CSS. However, we still need HTML to create the actual links, okay. So for that purpose and for that only, there is a tag in the HTML and that tag is called anchor tag, a tag, okay, and it is used to create links of every kind. There are external link, there are internal links, and there, and you can also convert an image into a link. However, in this video we are going to talk about external links only, that is the links which connect your web page to the different web page on the internet, okay. So let me just go to the notepad and let's see. So this is the file that we were working in the last video. Let me just go ahead and open a new file for the links, and you will have to go here in the language, select H and then HTML. Do not select Haskell, okay, Haskell is a different language, select HTML. Now the thing is that let me just write all the necessary codes really quick. So HTML, okay guys, so here we are in the body tag now, okay. So this is where we will start writing our codes, okay, about links. So the anchor tag is actually represented like this, a tag, okay, a, okay. Now capital case A or small case A, it doesn't matter, okay, because the HTML is actually a case not a case sensitive language. That means lowercase letters and uppercase letters are actually same. So this is the anchor tag, okay. Anchor tag is used to create links for everything, whether you are trying to create internal links, external links, or you wanna make an image as a link, okay. However, you are going to use an attribute of the anchor tag. Now that attribute is actually href, that is, let me just write here href. href means href, okay. Href means the full form of href, this attribute is hypertext reference, h for hypertext, and then ref, that is ref, is for reference, okay, hypertext reference. That means it is just a reference for a text, for a link, okay. Now in this attribute you will have to provide a value, and that value will be the link of the web page where you want the user to land after clicking the text. Okay, so let's say you want him to go to the, let's say google.com. So you can just go ahead and write www.google.com. okay, and then you just have to close the inverted commas and boom, the first part of the link is complete. Okay, now you just have to write here something that user can actually see and click on. Okay, so I'm gonna just write here link for Google. Okay, and then you have to close the anchor tag also. You must close the anchor tag. Okay, now we have created a link for google.com. okay, now let me tell you guys that I don't have a Wi-Fi connection at this moment, so it will not be possible for me to show you that it actually goes to the google.com. okay, however I have some external web pages on my desktop which I can actually link on with this web page. So let me just show you how you can do that. Okay, and you can do that, do this with any web page. Okay, so A and then href. Remember, HTML is actually not a case sensitive language, so you can just write capital case or lowercase, whatever you wish to. Okay, now let me just go ahead and let me just copy the name. Okay, these are the three files that we have created in the previous video: list in HTML, inserting images, and HTML doc. Okay, now as I'm gonna save this file, the link file, in the same place as I have stored all the other files, I just have to write the name of the file that I want to link, that is the name of the web page that I want to link, and the extension. Okay, so let's say HTML doc, I want to link this web page. Okay, because on the internet when you will upload these websites, it will become web page. Okay, you can go ahead and link these web pages also. So I'm just gonna go ahead and write HTML doc dot htm, HTML doc dot htm. Okay, however let me tell you guys, if you are like not storing this file in the same folder as the other files, then you will actually have to specify the entire path of the web page that you are trying to reach to. Okay, and that's why we use https and all that stuff. However, we won't be using that because all of our files are right here. Okay, now just like I'm gonna just give it a text like a link for HTML doc. Okay, and then you have to close the anchor tag. Once you close the anchor tag, your link is actually ready. Okay, now I'm just gonna close the body tag also, and then HTML tag, and I'm just gonna save it. Okay, I'm gonna save it in the desktop. Go to the desktop and I'm just gonna save it like link.htm, because I like htm. okay, you can also give it a .html tag extension, but I like to give .htm. okay, there are two possible choices for us, so I'm just gonna use .htm. so we have saved our web page, and it is time to go ahead and test the web page out. Okay, so this is the web page, as you can see here, just double click it. Okay, and this is the link. Okay, this is actually stored right now in our desktop, in our computer. So so that's what the path, the URL actually looks like. Okay, however if it was stored on the internet, okay, on some hosting platform like Bluehost or any other place, then the URL would be like https://, and then www dot the site name, and then the whole link, the whole path of that web page. Okay, so as you can see here, we have two links, link for Google and link for HTML doc. Once I click here, it tries to take me to the google.com. okay, but the file was not found. Why? it first searches your computer for the file and then internet. Okay, since I never created something like a google.com, so it did not work. Now it is time for this one, link for HTML doc. Since we have already created a HTML doc, as you can see here, the HTML doc, this file, the web page actually opened. Okay, as you can see here, this actually opens up, and you can just click on the back button to go back, and boom, you have created your first very external link. Okay, now let me tell you guys that let's say you want to change the colors of the link. For example, you want to show the visited link in different color, unvisited link in different color. You want to change the color when you hover the mouse over a link. Then for that purposes, for all those formatting purposes, there is CSS. Okay, you will have to learn CSS. Do not try to do something like that with the help of HTML, because it will be messy, guys. Okay, it will be really, really messed up, because you are not gonna like format every single link on your web page. You just have, because that will be really tedious. So using an external style sheet, that is using CSS, is far more better, because you just have to create it once and then apply it to all of your web pages, and boom, that's it. So do not try to format stuff with the help of HTML. That's just a pain in the ass, that's all. So let's go. So this is the links we have created right now, okay, and these are the external links we have just created. Now guys, there is a way to create internal links. For example, you are creating a very big web page, and now you want to link the different parts of the same web page, okay, so that user will not have to like scroll down a lot to reach at a certain place in your web page. You can do that with the help of links, okay. Those are called as internal links. However, there is a different way of implementing those, and we will be talking about those links in the next video, okay, that is in the part 7 of the HTML5 series that is going on this channel, okay. So if you want that, then please comment, and if you have like any query, if you think that there is something I missed here, then just feel free to go ahead and comment, okay. I will include everything that you think I have missed in the next video, and yeah, that will benefit a lot of people, guys, okay. So do not hesitate to comment, okay, and you can also join me on the Twitter, and I have already provided the link for Twitter account, and then yeah guys, and please subscribe guys, because I post content like this every day, and a lot of other things are also going to come up, like reviews on books and the sources from where you can actually start learning code. Because if you are like just getting into, then there is a lot on the internet which can actually overwhelm you. So I'm gonna make videos about those things also, the resources and the good resources, okay, because there are some like bad and totally idiotic and just money making resources on the internet which are really harmful for the beginners, okay. So I'm gonna make videos on like good resources, from where you should learn and from where you should not and all. So so for those videos, please subscribe guys, and like this video if you think that this was a little bit helpful for you guys. So and that's it for this video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe the channel, and thank you guys for watching. Till the next video, goodbye.